In the last decade, an all-time favourite of science enthusiasts, Elon Musk, has confidently promoted the use of electric vehicles across the world. But are electric cars really that great for the environment? And are they the ultimate solution to aligning the transport industry with what's required to curb climate change? This is Dynamic Science, and in today's video, we are going to debunk some of the common beliefs about electric vehicles. Along with Tesla, many other manufacturers of electric vehicles market their products as a clean and healthy alternative to vehicles that use fossil fuels for energy. However, the debate on the credibility of these statements is still quite hot. The world's population of 7.8 billion people is an ever-growing number. And with so many of us still utilizing transport that runs on fossil fuels, it is one of the major contenders in contributing greenhouse gases to the atmosphere. Almost one quarter of total carbon emissions comes from the transportation industry, and almost three quarters of this is due to road vehicles. One may look at this data and conclude that if all vehicles ran on electricity, we could revolutionize the entire industry. But at what cost are we willing to achieve this? First, let's look at the numbers. On an average, the amount of greenhouse gases emitted to produce a combustion engine car is approximately 10 to 12 tons. This is including everything from mining iron ores to when the car is ready for sale. From here, we add on how much the car emits per year, which is around 4.6 metric tons. And lastly, we have to take into account the extraction of the fossil fuels themselves, such as petroleum and diesel. So let us add another approximately 280 billion tons of greenhouse gases per year. Safe to say, the carbon footprint leaves one in absolute awe. Now, let us look at an electric vehicle. There is approximately 17 to 18 tons emitted to produce the car itself. And as electric cars are only as green as the energy you charge them with, in countries with coal-intensive power plants, currently they can have similar lifetime emissions to the most efficient conventional vehicle. However, as countries do decarbonize electricity to meet their climate targets, driving and manufacturing emissions will continue to fall. Take the UK in 2019, for example. The lifetime emissions per kilometre for a Nissan Leaf EV were about three times lower than the average conventional car. But here comes the eye-openers that most do not consider. An average EV uses approximately 10 kilograms of lithium with a significant amount of cobalt in it. A ton of lithium makes a maximum of 90 EVs. Mining a ton of lithium emits over 15 tons of carbon dioxide, and don't forget to add the other greenhouse gases on top of this. Also, mining lithium requires water, lots and lots of water, almost 2 million litres of it, just to produce one ton of lithium. These mines use up all the water in the surrounding areas, along with depositing graphite dust particles on the ground, making the land surrounding the mines unfertile. Thus, any farmers close by generally become unemployed. Further to this, the major deposits of lithium are located near some of the most sensitive ecosystems in the world. In 2016, a toxic chemical leak from a lithium mine in Upper Tibet led to the complete destruction of the surrounding ecology, with thousands of dead fish being found washed up on the banks of Liqui River. The future of our so-called clean energy depends on lithium. And to make matters worse, it is not only used in vehicles, but in many other everyday devices, such as our smartphones and many cities' electricity backup systems. By 2025, lithium consumption is expected to be tripled. But this is still not even the worst part of the entire process. Most of the cobalt that EVs need is taken from parts of Africa, one of the poorest continents, where child labour and labour exploitation are both unaccounted for. It is time we ask ourselves whether our methods of saving the planet are appropriate. Yes, we not only need to electrify the transportation industry, but all sectors, everywhere. But is there a more ethical and eco-friendly way of doing this? And if we are successful, are generations from now going to look back at how we conducted ourselves and think, exploiting the land and people at all costs was the correct path? To sacrifice so many for the greater good? I'll leave that one up to you. Enjoying the content? Then shout us a coffee. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for your weekly dose of dynamic science.